future young leader, Lara-Muckenschnabl, has been thinking about resumes. She's been thinking about job applications, and she's been thinking about the attraction and the recruitment of staff. So, how might agriculture change the game of recruitment? Can we attract the best and the brightest? Can we attract young people by doing recruitment in a radically different way? Malkah is a relationship credit analyst at Agribusiness at ANZ and is one of our evokeAG 2023 future young leaders. Would you please welcome to the stage a big morning welcome for Lara-Muckenschnabl to evokeAG.
That was my resume. 7 seconds. That's the average time recruiters and managers spend reading a resume. That's honestly how long it takes to spell my last name, Muckenschnabel. I can't convey myself to you in 7 seconds, but I need that resume to impress so I can make it to the interview stage and show you who I am. It's fundamentally wrong and it needs a solution. Because otherwise, we're locking people out. And forbid you don't fit the system, you don't stand a chance. Talk about inclusion. How Serena Williams ended up cleaning toilets. Sounds funny, but that's basically my mum's story. She was a professional tennis player. She also had a whole career in agriculture. She worked on cattle stations and had her own ag consulting company. When she applied for a visa, she got it express because Australia was in demand for people with her experience. But then, she was right here in Adelaide cleaning toilets at a hotel because she couldn't find a job. That was 15 years ago. And now, my generation is experiencing the same thing. Because unless you specifically know that you want to be a marine biologist on Hamilton Island, you're on the number one job search engine in Australia. And I only have two requirements. I have an interest in agriculture, and I want to put my degree to use. But first, I have to pick an industry from the following options. Consulting and strategy, management, finance, government, legal, animals, farming, and conservation. That sounds like ag. I click on it, and I get wildlife ranger. Animal care officer, animal attendant. Not quite there yet, so I try again. 5 managing assistants, 4 technical officers, elephant walker, busker, and honestly, it's too hard. In the end, this essentially means that there is no filter for agriculture in the biggest job search engine in Australia. I'll let that sink in. So we have 2 very different situations with 1 ongoing systemic issue: barriers to finding a job in agriculture. And it's hard not to fear that the industry is relying on its networks. And that got me thinking, well, what is it about networks that is so effective and makes you get the job? Well, networks tell us what a resume can't. The skills that can't be taught, the communication skills, the culture fit, the self-motivation, and the passion for the industry. In fact, I would say this is one of agriculture's biggest differentiators. Just think about regional communities, your local footy netball club, your farmer's market, your local show, or the neighbour who helped you through the floods. When I did my graduate rotations across Bendigo, Orange, and Swan Hill, it was the people that could make or break my experience, not the job. That's why the best interviews are the ones where you walk out and think, I just talked about what the Adelaide Crows can do to win the next flag for 40 minutes. That's because rapport can't be taught. But what if you don't have the right network? Or what if you're new to the industry? Then we go all the way back to square one where I've got just 7 seconds to make an impression using a resume. So what if we change the game? Imagine a dating app for jobs. I've called it Lymbo, and this is my prototype. Think about it. It's not that different to dating. You can always teach someone how to do the dishes, but whether they have the voluntary drive and willingness to do them is something else. You want someone good for the role, but good for me means something entirely different to you. Lymbo connects people in our voice, in our language, in our style of communication. It opens up the recruitment process, makes it more fun and more accessible. Where someone like my mum, who didn't have a someone who knew someone who knew someone, could tell her story. Suddenly, she's more than just a resume. Lymbo would mean that businesses are not just a boring job requirement. They come alive with a day in the life of the role video, a scroll through Meet the Team, or a link to a podcast talking about the next cool project. It's simple. The non-negotiable skills, like the need for a driver's license or willingness to relocate, are matched in the background, and the focus is on the person and the connection. Because a job is more than filling an empty seat. It's what we do for most of our lives. Why agriculture? I'll ask you a question. What is agriculture? Because to me, especially after being in evoke, it's engineering, it's technology, it's science, it's farming, and now we're even talking about it in the context of space. That's why this is so important to agriculture, because I'll tell you what it isn't. Just farming, animals, and conservation. But how do you tell someone this? That agriculture is all of this and more? You can't. You have to show them. So I ask, are you ready to change the game with me? Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Malkah-Muckenschnabl. I've loved working with you and all of the future young leaders, but very quickly, what does it mean for you to be here at evoke and be part of this movement?
Everything. I think I've, you know, this yesterday morning the introduction was, it's all about the people, and I think this speaks of that. It's evoke, we're connecting everyone from all over Australia with all different, from all different facades of agriculture. So I think this is it. It's us, it's the people, it's the conversations we have and the networks that we meet.
And when I hear people like Malkah, I feel so optimistic about the future and what next. Can we hear it for Malkah again?